So I've done some exploratory grinding, and this part here is solid. Absolutely solid. This looks like Rover, the original Rover rubberized plastic or whatever material they used, the Underseal plus the paint. And underneath it's shiny metal. And there's no pushing, there's no crunching sounds or anything like that. I mean, obviously it's gone here. Now, on the Rover R8, manufacturers put on, and it was a really lousy design, they put on a rubber finishing strip all along here. And that finishing strip, which didn't really need to be there, just trapped water. And that's what this had, and it's gone on the edge. And even this isn't too, I know there's bits missing, but I've seen a lot worse. You can see the layers. This is the, obviously the outer skin, and this is the, as far as I can tell, the inner arch. So the inner lip here is part of this. But I think instead of sanding this stuff, I might just use a hot air gun, soften it up and scrape it off. But I don't need to replace this bit. Obviously I'm going to check with a hammer and just go round it, because it'll be repainted anyway. So this actually is in better condition, certainly on this side. Obviously there is a jacking point that's gone here, but I'm going to have to sand that down to see what's there. But it's okay, so I know I've got to replace this, but it's doable. It's not impossible. In fact, you can see now this has still got the primer on it. That is the original primer or electrophoretic coating, I don't know, whatever they called it, of this part. I've had to kind of cable tie the light to the spring, because I haven't got a magnetic light. I think that'll be next on the list. I'm going to take some of the Underseal off on here as well to make sure that's not just been covered up, because Rover R8s and the 3-door and the 5-door, 4-door, whatever, they can rust here as well, which means the seatbelt mount will fail. But I'm going to check under that. But this is remarkably good condition. Let me just put the light on for you so you can see. I can't fit under this bit. Excuse the hands. So it does appear some of it is actually just surface rust. If you can see down in the seal, don't know if I can actually get. Hello. Well, that's not too bad either. Obviously, I'm going to have to. I've got a little boroscope I'm going to send up there. Surface rust. Might even be the old wax, I don't know. But I was expecting a lot worse. I mean, it's still going to be a challenge to rebuild this bit. I mean, I have got a panel for, I think it's this side anyway. I know I've only got one side, so I'm going to have to take some very careful measurements. Because this is the original panel, I'm going to take measurements off this and try and duplicate it on the other side. Obviously the minimum amount of removal, because I don't want to end up having to, it'll be very difficult to blend in a large panel, certainly if I'm not used to it. This is a whole different league for me, doing this sort of body repair. So I'm going to be taking the time. What else? At least the brakes are still free, because I left the handbrake off, because it's been parked up here for about five. It must be coming up for 5 years now. It's not too bad a condition. So. Next stage will be, I'm going to try the hot air gun on the rest of this, and then I can start making measurements. This is actually a good result. This is original metal and it's absolutely perfect. All the rust is where the sill meets the jacking point and the wheel arch, but everything else, I'm actually quite amazed at this, because this is a 1992 car and it's the last 5 years it's been in the dry garage. But I have to say, Rover's, I know I mentioned it in one of the other videos, but Rover's Underseal or rubberized coating is incredible. So long as it doesn't get breached, it absolutely stays intact. And I've had to heat, as you've seen, it up to soften it to get it off. Very difficult to use. I didn't want to really use mechanical method because it just puts a lot of dust and stuff in the air. Obviously heating it up isn't much better, but it's quicker. But this is absolutely perfect. I mean, I've seen R8s where they've just rotted out here, up into here. This is the sill closing panel. But yeah, apart from that lip, that bit there is always where mud and stones sort of build up and it just eats into the metal. But on the whole, I'm quite pleased with this. Right, now to work out some templates, certainly for this bit, and find out exactly how difficult it is to fit a lower quarter. Right, onwards and upwards.